Thank you. That are pianists probably recognize these four pieces, but as a violinist, I'm not really familiar with them. And this is a wonderful arrangement Dr. Smart arranged for violin and piano, so you were hearing it for the very first time. And so it's been really, really fun for me to discover these Greek pieces that are, again, just full of characters and all these really neat stories behind it. The next sonata that we are going to play is the original composition by Dr. Smart, and I think all the titles and everything probably would maybe be more interesting if Dr. Smart could kind of share a little bit of all these various dances and styles that he's inspired and tried to write, and I think you will enjoy hearing the inspiration behind that.
Sure. I wrote this piece about 10 years ago, and it's been revised twice since then. I wrote it for a fine violinist, Dr. Shiao knew well, Rexandra Marquardt. She was Romanian. She's since moved on now, works in New Mexico. And it was my relationship with Rexandra that inspired the last movement. What I did, and I'm interested in this in a lot of my compositions, I like to borrow or interact with different world musics, different styles of music. Seems to me, well, it's called pluralism, but seems to me it's very American. We're a nation of immigrants. We like different things. And often they come together and create new things. That also is what America is about. But this is not a particularly patriotic piece, that's just where it comes from. The first movement is influenced by African music. I didn't say jazz, African music. Now kalimba, maybe some of you know what it is, you see ads for them on Instagram and Facebook and so forth. They're a little box, like there's a resonating box, with metal prongs attached, and you play with your thumbs. It's called a thumb piano sometimes. It's a typically West African instrument. delicate, but it's extremely percussive. It's about rhythmic polyphony, many voices of rhythm. That's where this movement started from. It's probably all you need to know about it. Listen for the rhythm, listen for the sound of pizzicato, plucked strings, and I try to imitate that on the piano. The second movement, probably most of you are a little more familiar with, the habanera. It's a Spanish dance. Boom, bum, kind of the rhythm. Often very lyrical, certainly mine is. I think that takes care of itself. It's a little invocation of late romanticism in a modern way. The last movement, I think, is pretty unique. It's called Impartita, and that's a Romanian dance. Thank goodness for the internet. Who knows how I would have ever run into the Impartita without the internet? But I listened to some folk dancing and watched them dance, and they dance in constantly changing meters. You know, usually a waltz is in 3/4 all the way through, a march is in 4/4 all the way through. But their music does 3/8, 7/16, 2/8, 4/4, and then asymmetrical completely. And yet they stay together, and it's very interesting. They even have, talk about American influence, they have jazz groups, and they play in these strange rhythms, and they stay together. It feels right to them. It's hard for us to stay together, but we're going to try tonight. In playing these difficult multi-rhythms. It also, I think, sounds rather East European in the scales and modes that I use. But that's it. Three very contrasting movements that explore what the piano and the violin can do, and also national styles. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
As a violinist, growing up, there are all these wonderful recordings of Joshua Heifetz and Misha Elman and all these really just, for us, still the very, very top tiers of this violin tradition. And all these wonderful violinists were from Odessa, Ukraine. And of course, we're all heartbroken with what is happening nowadays over there. And this is a really wonderful melody by Ukrainian composer Skoryk, and has been very much in a sort of a rallying cry for the last couple of years with this melody. So our hearts goes out to them. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.